Hello and welcome to the SEABL preview show. I'm your host, Rohan Short, and don't adjust your computer screens just yet. I'm not Oprah Winfrey, aka Beth Davis, and this isn't Kyrie Irving, but we got the next best thing, definitely the next best thing, in Nathan Crosswell. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, thanks, mate. Looking forward to a little word with Shorty today. It should be good.
Good. I'm excited about having you here too. First of all, straight off the bat, 34-year-old?
Almost. 34 in August.
You know, retired now from the NBL. Yep. Were you humbled by, you know, all the messages of support and for coming out of the NBL and retiring and everything that you achieved?
Yeah, I guess you know, when I decided to make the decision to retire, I never expected, you know, the amount of love or the amount of people that actually, not that they care, but people that knew about it and knew about basketball and that I was retiring. It was really humbling, and you know, it's something I'll never forget as a basketballer.
And obviously now at Sandringham, the team's 9-13, sixth in the East Conference, on a bit of a two-game slide. What's been the biggest challenge for the Sabres this year?
Yeah, look, it certainly has been a challenging year. You know, I can't question the guys' work ethic or endeavour, or, you know, the way that we're playing. We're playing hard. We've had, we were just talking about the other day, we had four games that we've lost by, you know, whether it be going into overtime or, you know, a last second shot on the buzzer. It's been frustrating. Had we won two of those, we might be pushing the finals right now. But, you know, the good thing about Sandringham right now is that we've got probably eight of our 12 players are all kids that they've brought up through the junior programs from 14s to 16s, 18s and onwards, and now playing SEABL. So they're all getting great minutes into them, and, you know, we will benefit from that probably more next year than we will this year.
Now, I know you're not one for personal statistics and accolades and all those sorts of things, but your form this year has been really solid. I mean, you're averaging 13 points and 4 assists a game, so you're doing quite well. Has your role shifted in the last couple of years here with Sandringham when you've come back, and what is it now?
Yeah, I guess now it's more about helping to develop the younger guys that we've got. You know, we've got Alistair McDonald, who's with the Melbourne Tigers development player, Josh Wilshire, Lockie Winter. There's another couple of guards, Steph. Yeah, there's a few guys there that I'm really enjoying working with and mentoring a little bit and helping, you know, share a little bit of my experiences, I guess, with them to help them get better. And then, you know, Dean's kind of come to me throughout the year and said, look, I really need you to start to look for your own a little bit more and score, because, you know, I still can do that.
Now, last weekend you had an absolute barn burner against the Geelong Supercats, yeah. Obviously one of the informed teams of the competition. 93-92, take us through. Did you have a chance to win that game?
Oh, we felt we did. And like I said, we continually putting ourselves in positions to win games, and it was no different on the weekend. You know, we got up four halfway through the fourth, 4 points, and, you know, the team that they are, the good team that they are, they grinded us back and got back in front, and it was kind of back and forth a little bit. You know, we couldn't really get our noses in front. We got a great stop with about 8 seconds to go and pushed the ball down the floor, and, you know, I had a little drive to the left, surprise, surprise. And they cut me off, and I just dropped it back to Josh Wilshire. He had a wide open three, and, yep, you know, had that gone down, then we'd be sitting here really happy today. But, you know, we're still 9-13, as it says here, and battling away. But, you know, we are playing the best teams pretty well at the moment.
But also, Mike Mercer was player of the week with 23 points and 4.5 rebounds across his 2-0 weekend. Terrific performance over the weekend.
Oh, absolutely. I walked away from our game on Saturday night, you know, just really impressed. You know, he, real humble guy. He wasn't out there trash talking. He was just out there playing the game of basketball, which I love guys that are like that.
Yeah.
He's a pretty good package. He can shoot the ball okay. He gets to the rim. He gets his team involved, and he's a pretty good rebounder for his size.
Now let's get on to the rounds this weekend. Sandringham and Hobart on Saturday night. Hobart obviously in third place in the South Conference, but you obviously won that game in round three against them pretty early on. You may not have even been playing with the team at that stage, were you?
No, I wasn't. That, you know, our team's really changed, you know, since that weekend. We've got Patrick Richard in now and myself, obviously, and, you know, we're playing a little bit. We feel like we're playing, you know, as good as we've played, but, you know, from all accounts, the boys really battled tough down there to get two wins, and you know, we're really looking forward to the challenge this week. Should be a good game.
Then up the highway on the afternoon of Sunday, yes, coming up against the Ballarat Miners, who are really struggled this season, sitting seventh in the South Conference with a record of 6-17. You did beat them in round 12, but obviously the return of Sean Bruce, who's coming back from an injury, will make them an extremely different side.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Sean didn't play, and Lucas Walk actually didn't play that night either. So, you know, we're under no illusion that it's going to be a tough game, you know, especially going down there. They tend to play pretty good at home. And it's just proving that, you know, the league, the SEABL League this year is really tough, and that, you know, you cannot take any team lightly, and if you do, you're going to get beat. And, you know, we've got to go in there with a mindset that we got to win two this weekend, and, you know, our finals really depend on getting two wins this weekend. So, you know, it's going to be a great challenge.
All right, well, just looking at this week's fixtures, we might go to some social media questions that people have left for you. Joe Wilcher from Sandringham, believe it or not, asked me to ask you on Facebook why you're no longer allowed to drive the rental buses anymore.
Oh, well, yeah, that's a nice one. Well, I'm sure I could still drive them if I like. No, down in Tassie, going to a game in Hobart, and I just might have clipped the side of the rental bus there a little bit. Nothing
really
too sinister, but...
Yeah, didn't need to report it, no?
Well, we are now, aren't we? No, it was not much in it, but not my proudest moment.
Well, fair enough. And Alice McDonald, also from Sandringham, you've got a lot of fans here down here in Sandringham, wants to know, is it true you were 100 kgs at your playing weight back in your NBL in the early days? 100 kgs.
Yeah, well, it's funny, some people, the story gets bigger and bigger, but I was 103 was probably the biggest I topped out. I played about 80 now, but no, I was probably not treating the game of basketball the respect it deserved in those days, and... Yeah, mind you, I could still get up and dunk at 103 kilos, so I thought that wasn't too bad. But no, I'll never be back to that weight again, but that is absolutely true.
And up next, we've got the Who Got Next segment with Josh Dirksen from the Brisbane Spartans.
Josh Dirksen, Brisbane Spartans, and I play probably a small forward. I first started playing when I was in grade 7 and played in Toowoomba, either receiving a college scholarship to Bellarmine University or winning a silver medal at the Under 17 Worlds last year. Well, definitely starting from this season, Dan George definitely became a role model. Just everything he went through. Talking about NBA players, probably look up to Larry Bird, was always someone I watched a lot growing up, and Kevin Durant now, definitely. I'm part of the Active After School Cares program, and once or twice a week I go down to a local school or something for an hour or an hour and a half and just do some drills and stuff with the little kids, so it's good, they enjoy it. Shout out to my dad for helping me along the way, my family, and Coach Scheibner. Thanks for everything, mate.
That was Josh Dirksen from the Brisbane Spartans. And Crozzy, how'd you get involved in the game of basketball?
Yeah, I started following my dad around. My dad used to play. I'm from Ballina in northern New South Wales. So he used to play at a few different places around the area, and I used to just follow him around and, you know, getting out there and shooting the basketball before games, at halftime, after the games, and really started to love it and enjoy it, and you know, kind of started playing from there.
And in the SEABL shootout segment this week, we have Jack Duck from the Albury Wodonga Bandits. Let's see how he goes. Of course, we've come to the end of the show, and you know, what would be the show without a SEABL quickie? Are you happy to have a quickie with
you? Absolutely, I'm in.
Looking forward to it.
There we go.
All right, answer quickly then. What teammate is most likely to forget their hotel room key?
Oh, Josh Wilshire.
And what's the greatest highlight to you? Hawthorn defeating Geelong in the 2008 Grand Final, or the fact that you played more NBL games than Stephen Hall?
Oh,
it's a tough one.
Yeah. Hawthorn.
Yeah, good. True or false, did Stephen Hall score over 50 points on Andrew Bogut in a SEABL game?
Oh, false, surely?
I'm sorry, it's true.
Well, true,
you have to go back to the record books, but I think he had 53 on Andrew Bogut, another Wadding one year.
It's a one he hasn't reminded me about that one.
Well, he never tells anyone, I always tell him. Have you ever been mistaken for looking like NBL assistant coach Liam Flynn?
I have, plenty of times. Surprise, surprise, there was one time up in Townsville that Liam went out and lived on my name all night, so it's definitely happened.
And what teammate, former or current, is most likely to be arrested?
Oh,
this is a quickie.
Yeah, that's not really. I'll say Rasul Hinder.
He would
Russell be. Hinder would probably be the one that that comes to my mind.
And what is your advice for aspiring SEABL athletes?
Aspiring SEABL athletes, just get in there and have a go. Like I said earlier, we've got 8 kids that we've brought through from our junior program now to be playing in SEABL, and I kind of say the same thing to them, that you never know how long it's going to last, so you might as well give it a crack while you're in it. And you never know what could come. If someone had asked me 15 or 16 years ago, or said to me that I'd play 350 NBL games, win a championship, I would have told them that you were dreaming. So just get in there and give it a go, and you never know what can happen.
So that's about it for today, and thanks for joining us, Nathan.
Yeah, thanks, mate. Appreciate it. Just before we go, obviously you've been a little bit busy over the last few months.
I have.
Fill the viewers in with what you've been up to.
Yeah, obviously just come back from Russia where the World University Games were, and I don't think people really understand the magnitude of the event. There's, over 12,000 athletes, 170 countries.
Yep.
It's like a mini Olympics. And, obviously from a basketball front, the Australian men did really well, taking home a silver medal. And a massive turning point for Australian basketball in a lot of ways, to showcase some of the new exciting talent we have on the world stage. We upset the Americans. That rattled them for the rest of the tournament. We beat Lithuania and Serbia, teams that we traditionally have had a lot of trouble with. And to play in front of 10,000 people in Russia against Russia in a gold medal game was pretty special. So a wonderful experience. It's glad to be back, and I'm glad to be down here at Sandringham, which is a great club. And thanks for joining us this week on the SEABL preview show. Make sure you get to all the SEABL games this week with it wearing yellow, because it is the call to arms round and raising awareness for cancer in men. Join us on our social media channels as well, and we'll see you next week on the SEABL preview show.